Hey YouTube, today I want to take a look at some HEVC video files that I have and how I'm going to convert them to a format that works well with macOS High Sierra, iOS 11, and TVOS 11. I know this would be very popular. A lot of people want to convert their videos, especially if you have a large TV or movie collection. Me personally, I have about 16 terabytes of data stored locally, so I'm really excited to convert all my data over. It'll save me quite a bit, especially in cloud backups. If you're using a cloud backup service, this will really save you a lot. Now, there's a few different formats floating around, and the reason I wanted to do this video was to show you how to remixture, hopefully save you guys some time in converting so that you don't have to completely convert your videos over. I have two examples here that I'm going to use. This may vary for you, and this only will work for Mac. I don't have a solution for Windows yet, but I'll take a look at it, see what I can post for you guys. Two of these applications I'm going to be using are paid applications. One of them is free. The two paid applications are quite a bit quicker than the free alternative, but to each their own. So we're going to start by taking a look at the two different containers that are very popular around the internet right now, which would be the MKV container and the M4V container, which is actually an MP4 container. You can see now these do not direct play on macOS High Sierra, which I'm on right now. So these files would require conversion to play natively. That means if you're streaming with Plex or you're streaming even with VLC, it's still going to have to perform a software conversion. So we'll take a look at these files quickly here in an application called Media Info. You can get this on the App Store, and it is not necessary, but it does give you a breakdown of the audio and video video in the container here, so you can see which application made it, the variable bit rate, and the audio streams, and then you can also confirm that your video codec is HEVC. Same thing with the M4V file, same thing. So how do we convert these? So I have two options. The first one I'll start with is the free option. It's the long option. It's the one that's going to take a while. And this is Handbrake. Handbrake is known by a lot of Mac, Windows, Linux users. It is a really great application, free application, and it will convert all of your media. Some of it isn't hardware decoded, so depending on the system you're using, the graphics card, this might use CPU to convert, which means it will take a very, very long time. As an example here, I have the Rick and Morty episode loaded, and if we go here and change to the HEVC codec, I'm going to choose just fast. So this is just the basic presets. I'm not going to get into presets with Handbrake here, and then we'll set my destination to converted HEVC. So when I hit, I just have to change the directory really quickly, and we hit begin. You will see an average 25 minute movie or TV show or video, home video, will take you approximately 30 to 35 minutes, even longer, to convert. So this is your first option. As long as you're using the nightly build, so if we head back here, you go to downloads, nightly builds. So make sure that you're using the nightly build, because the general release here, unfortunately, is not compatible with the latest macOS High Sierra. So let's get into a faster way to do this. This is probably what you guys are actually here for. So I have an application that I purchased back in 2013 on the App Store, and it just got updated. So I'm not, again, this is a $10 application. Unfortunately, I don't have a free way to do this. If somebody has a free way to do this, I would love to hear it. Please post in the comments, and then I will make a video. For now, unfortunately, $10 is the best to do this quickly. So what is MKV to MP4? Basically, it is an application that will convert the audio and remixture the container. So you don't have to re-encode the video. This will save massive amounts of time when you're converting from an MKV to the MP4 format used by Apple now, so the HEVC. So as long as your video has, or the video that you're going to convert is using the HEVC codec, which we verified using the media info application, which is just right here. So as long as you have an HEVC MP4 container, this should work. And it is really as simple as dragging, designating the area you'd like it to put this file, and hitting begin. Now you can see how fast this conversion is going. The only thing it's converting right now is the audio from the FLAC to the AAC, which will be compatible with the Apple TVs, your iOS 10 or whatever. Once the conversion is complete, you can see now I actually get a preview. And if I were to start playing this video, which I'll have to block this, sorry guys, but the video is now compatible with the macOS High Sierra. This will direct stream through Plex. Now, I have another example here, and I couldn't figure out what to do. What happens when you have an MP4 container and an M4V? Now, I want to show you guys, M4V is MP4. You will not corrupt the video by changing the extension. So I'm going to change the extension right here from M4V to MP4. And as you can see here, I still don't get the preview because this video, the container created, is not compatible. So what do we do about this? Well, initially I thought that I had to re-encode a lot of my videos, and I was pretty upset about this because re-encoding with Handbrake, like as you've seen, can be 30 to 40 minutes per episode. That's quite a bit of conversion time. So what I discovered was, again, we can use MKV to MP4 to remixture this container into a compatible container that will work with the latest macOS iOS releases. The first thing you need to do is you have to change this. So if you have an M4V file, you will not be able to use it in MKV to MP4. Now, I've actually emailed the developer and asked him to add this extension, as it makes no difference. But currently, you do have to manually change the extension to MP4. And then just like the MKV, we will remixture. Now, the only thing is, you can't remixture into the same folder. So remember to select a different folder so it doesn't try to rewrite the video that you're remixturing. And you will see here the conversion once again. It's going to convert the audio, the incompatible audio. And now in our new folder here, I can move it back up. We have a container that is compatible with the macOS High Sierra, iOS 11, same one. And so that's how you can convert your video files over to the new HEVC format. If you are using an older format and you're wanting to convert to the newer format, you will have to use Handbrake. MKV to MP4 is just a container remixer, so this is only useful if you already have HEVC content. So this isn't going to convert non-HEVC content to HEVC. Just for that note, you will have to do Handbrake, and there really is no other way around it right now to speed it up. But still, this is great news for all of us with like tons and tons of data. Like I said, I've got stacks of hard drives that sit here and hum all day long. 16 terabytes of rated data. I've got about 18 terabytes on hand. So having this is going to be really huge for me in the future for saving data. And I also believe it'll be huge for everybody else. Thank you, Apple, for adopting HEVC. It is really necessary that we keep up with this new technology that's coming out. And because you're such an influence in the tech community, it's nice to see that when you adopt something that the rest of the world adopts it. So that's pretty cool. Thank you again. Thanks everybody for watching this channel. Subscribe to the video, or subscribe for more videos. If you didn't like this video, give it a thumbs down. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Like I said, if you have another way of doing this, please comment in the description below. I will review it and possibly make a video on it. Thanks again. We'll see you guys again next time.